Hi everyone, how are you all doing? Art Kitten here. Wow, this is my first video. I finally made it, yay! I wanted to make it last week as I said I would, but I'm still recovering from my sickness, so sorry if I sound a little bit off, coupled with a weird accent. And my microphone isn't the best of quality, but it'll have to do. You know, at first I wasn't sure if I wanted to make a video at all. There are some things I've been saying I want to address for a few weeks now, but after I realized there is a lot I want to talk about, this would have been an absolutely huge post that I feel not many people would want to read, and I felt like you deserved the proper interaction from me for once, so here we are. As I've been hinting it earlier, I have a bunch of stuff to talk about concerning my work. But first, I want to personally thank each and every one of you who have supported me in these 4 years I've been active, whether it's in form of personal commissions or simply liking my stuff and following me. To me, it has been absolutely incredible to see so many of you being invested in my stuff, even when I'm just first starting. I read each of your messages, and even if sometimes I cannot reply quickly or reply at all, know that every show support means the world to me and it puts a smile on my face. All of you have been incredibly supportive and have encouraged me to push myself further to be a better artist and a more hardworking person in general. I've officially started with digital art in 2016, and since then I've learned a lot, improved a lot, through almost daily practice and countless of hours spent drawing, as well as receiving helpful advice from artists I admire. I believe that I'm at a level now where I can say that I'm finally happy with the results of my work. Well, much happier than I was before. I've got still ways to go, and it's true that real work and learning lasts for the rest of your life. But seeing your own progress and drawing how you pictured yourself you wanted to draw 4 years ago and all the results of your hard work feels incredibly rewarding. With that being said, I've always faced a problem with myself and with my art. It hasn't all been sunshine and rainbows, in fact, most of the time it's not. The main problem was that there was never a clear focus in what I draw. Not for long anyways. Part of that is due to my short attention span, so I get bored and distracted with the subject matter quite easily. I always want to move on to drawing something new, different. Well, that in itself isn't a bad thing, because knowing how to draw many different things is useful. I believe that offering something specific is beneficial to the artist and their audience in the long run. Another reason is due to the nature of learning itself. I never wanted to focus on just one thing. It takes years of trial and error and practice to learn how to draw different things when you're just a beginner. Basic things like anatomy, color theory, perspective work, mastering digital traditional tools, it all takes an enormous amount of time to learn and properly apply in your works, and especially if you're working with digital tools. For me, anyways. You see, I was in a constant state of this beginner stage. At first, I didn't know how to use digital tools and brushes, how to paint, had zero anatomy knowledge, you know, basically didn't know anything. So I was experimenting with 3D. Most of those Life is Strange artworks you guys love so much comes from that period of time. And for a while, I thought this was going to be enough for me. But no, it wasn't. I wanted to learn how to do, you know, pure digital paintings as well. So knowing how to mash pictures together, use a 3D program and brushes for paint always was useful as a starting point, and those tools can definitely help you improve. So after 4 years of experimenting and practice, digital art is something I love and see myself doing long term. I will still offer 3D as an option if somebody wants to commission that, and you know, in fact, it happened several times. And I will still probably do some Life is Strange artworks in this style of pure nostalgia, but I don't do it outside of that. But back to the main point, lack of focus. I've explained the reasons for it, but what does that mean thematically? It basically means that because I wanted to learn how to draw everything, I went all over the place. Creature concept art, character pose and faces study, comics, cutesy art, more realistic art, animals, humans, fantasy, fan art. 1 week I could have been drawing, you know, Pokemon, and another I'd switch to drawing my favorite pairings or griffins. While this was good for me, I could never escape the feeling it didn't feel good for most of my followers. After all, I'm putting my art out there for you. And you follow me because of a certain type of art you fancied and you hoped to see more of that. But I may have never delivered on it again. For that, I apologize. I understand the importance of artistic freedom. And while it's even necessary and freeing at times, I now strongly believe, after observing hundreds of artists I follow and look up to and learn from, that having a clear focus is the key to success in establishing a healthy relationship with your audience. It bothered me extremely that my own nature and need to learn new things was preventing me to committing to a certain theme for a longer than 2 weeks. Artists either build their brand by drawing, you know, a specific thing, for example, paleo art, pinups, fluffy animals, even food, or indulge in a healthy mix of themes. But they never go from one extreme to another. You won't see an artist that was drawing round-shaped animals for 5 years suddenly do a hard switch to porn art, for example. And that was my problem, as much as it was initially useful for trying to learn how to draw different things. I started neglecting what drew a lot of you in after a while, or I simply grew bored with it. It was perhaps a mistake on my end to think that I need to draw absolutely everything in order to keep everyone interested, because I didn't want to fall into the trap of drawing the same things over and over. What I lacked instead in my art was a fair balance. But now I have decided to put an end to that. I will explain everything, so listen carefully. With 4 years of experimenting and enough statistics collected to figure out what sort of things my audience likes the best, I will narrow down the themes of my artwork. Works that featured fan art, more specifically, Pokemon, female characters, pairings, are the ones that always reach out to most people on Twitter. On DeviantArt, original characters like cute animals and dinosaurs are very popular in comparison. Tumblr, it's a mixed bag of both, but Tumblr saw a massive decline in popularity since the adult stuff ban. And out of every theme, human characters were the most requested out of every commission I ever did, and even more so the not safe for work art, which I didn't post anywhere in most cases. In a recent Twitter and DeviantArt poll, in fact there were multiple polls, most of you voted for human characters when I asked what do you like seeing me draw the most. So, this is what is going to happen and what you can expect. Starting from next month, which is February, I'm going to split my artwork. I will have two Twitter accounts. This main account will feature human characters I draw only, and reblog, of course, which includes casual fan art and Patreon work, which will come later as requested. In fact, that will be the bulk of my work once it sets off. But the main point is human characters mostly. My second account, which I've recently created, will be used for everything else, including Pokemon, animals, fantasy, furry stuff, whatever. If there's a mix of the two, human characters featured in the same painting with creatures, it will be uploaded on both accounts. Why two accounts? Because, first, I don't want to alienate anyone who doesn't like a specific type of art, and since I was lumping everything together until now, I can 100% understand how it may have caused somebody to stop following me or be less interested because they dislike the mixed bag. Two, it's a good way to satisfy people who like seeing everything I draw, and it's really easy to follow me in two places. Three, recently I've been getting requests for furry art. This came as a bit of a surprise to me considering I never drew that stuff before, nor do I identify as one myself, but I found enjoyment in working on such commissions and I want that to be on my alternate account. And I may do some art on my own. You know, I want it on my second account. It's a niche type of art that I know it bothers some people. You know, just being fair. With all that being said, I am quite excited for the future, as I feel like I've finally found what I want to focus on. I enjoy drawing animals as much as my favorite characters and pairings, and it hurt thinking I couldn't focus on anything. So having at least on Twitter two accounts and having a clear focus on humans on my main one is a perfect solution for me. I struggled with my identity as an artist for a very long time. At some point last year, I didn't even know an answer to my own question. What is it that you draw? What are you known for? I couldn't find an answer to that. The final answer to that eventually was a bit of everything. I knew it was time for a change. I fell through kind of a crisis, not gonna lie. But I think I found a clear sense of direction, or at least I will definitely find it down the line. It took me longer than I thought it would, but I'm only looking forward now. I want to make it clear that I will not abandon one for the other theme, animals and humans, but depending what is most requested and best received, I may not focus on both equally. I hope that anyone who watches this understands where I'm coming from, and I in return will understand if some people feel disappointed, but I need to look out for myself too and focus on establishing my brand as an artist, as well as furthering my career as one. And that's something I never felt I could achieve with constant experimenting. Truth be told, I enjoy drawing not safe for work stuff a lot, something I felt I couldn't even post in most places at all, as I felt it wouldn't be appropriate. Now, I know it sounds weird, but it's like one time you log in and see a cute dinosaur, and next artwork you see from me is a bloody pinup. See, it wouldn't make any sense. So I want to focus on that as well, now that I'm trying to free myself of these constraints. I'm not exactly sure as of this day how I will handle this. I will either mark my main account as 18+, or post not safe for work stuff on my alternate account, not the one I mentioned earlier, but a third one, but I somehow doubt that will be the case. We'll see. I may post a poll to ask you guys directly about this, but eventually I will start offering such works behind my Patreon. It will be a fair compromise, you know, for those who don't wish to see that, and those who do can support me in exchange for access to such works. Again, Patreon stuff is something I will talk about in my next video in more detail. I believe that at the end of this year, I will establish myself even better and know what to keep pursuing. For those who will be inevitably disappointed in this, I sincerely apologize, but this is, you know, absolutely needed for me. I've had 4 years behind me, and I want to go back to what makes you guys happy, but without falling into the trap of feeling stuck into drawing the same things, never evolving as an artist, never trying new things. But I'm going to, like I said, find a fair balance. You're the ones I'm doing this for, and I sincerely enjoy when my work spark good and positive feelings in the viewer, and I want to continue pursuing that relationship. And of course, I'm doing it for myself. You know, artwork is basically my life. I want to do this. It brings me so much happiness, and it's just amazing to me. I will soon follow up with more details about my Patreon and an updated commission sheet in a new video. It will probably come live next week. I'm not sure. Most likely next Thursday. Thank you to everyone who watched this. I hope I didn't tire you with too much information. Feel free to discuss anything you want. You can ask me in the comments. Bye-bye. Thank you.